This one ought to be about ready to put on the drying rack.
It's pretty close. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We're all in on our triple malted grain. It's a standard recipe, but now we're bumping it up a notch by malting all three grains.
Dry that, grind it, put it in a barrel.
Right.
Well, let's get some of that barley and get with it. My buddy Ronald got a little farm on the outskirts of the county, and he got some barley that he was going to use for a cover crop that failed to do so. So we bought what he had left. At a bargain, we're keeping production costs down, and we can pass that on to our customers. Eddie, we got a problem.
Oh, hell.
We are infested with weevils. Look at it, Hattie. They're up under everything. They're all over the top of this, and they're under this, and they're over here. I promise you, they're in every one of these damn bags now. Damn. We yank sacks open, we're looking at them, and they're spreading like wildfire. They're like we are at the damn Golden Corral, and we go in when they come out of the bag to get fresh grain. Look at it. You know what weevils do, don't you?
They eat the damn middle of your grain up.
Good of your grain up. We can't sprout them when they eat the endosperm out of there. So these damn bugs are our enemy right now. There's going to be viable grain in there that'll germinate. I mean, they can't get to all of it this quick. We got to figure out a way that we can get rid of these bugs, kill them off, and save the seed.
What'll kill them won't kill our grain. Might fog them, one of them foggers.
It's worth a try. You got one of them?
Oh, yeah, I keep them. I do my house all the time. Let's take that bag of corn, see what it'll do. You know, corn is basically still the cheapest of the three, so we decide to practice on the corn. If we ruin it, that's not a big financial loss to us as, say, the rye or the barley. Are you ready to put that lid on it?
You ain't.
Whew. Having some weevils in our grain, yeah, you don't want them, but if you have a few, it's not the end of the world. You know, you just mash them in. They don't put off any adverse flavor. They don't create an issue at all. But it's a different ball game now that we're using this grain to malt. We have to actually sprout it. If they eat too much of the goody out of it, then it won't sprout. If it doesn't sprout, we produce no malt.
They're coming right down through. They're trying to get out of there, and they're dying down here. But you know what? Well, I can only imagine what it's going to do to the people we sell liquor to.
Oh, hell.
Didn't think that all the way through, did we? Maybe it won't saturate that grain too bad, but it can't be good for human consumption.
Do not apply when food is present. Exposed food should be covered or removed. Mm. Do not use in greenhouses where plants are grown for food. That's enough said.
Yeah, bad idea.
You know, we can't use this. We can't take a chance on hurting someone or making someone sick. I'm not willing to take that chance.
All I know is, Hattie, we got to figure out something to do to kill bugs that don't kill people in the liquor.
What really amazes me is how fast that they can decimate a bag of grain. I mean, we have to figure out a way to kill them all before weevils destroy the grain.
Well, let's go up here to the store and get us a bologna sandwich. While we're eating it, I'll talk to Dr. Google.
All right.
You know the best thing about bologna?
It ain't got no weevils in it.
Nope. Everybody gets a center cut.
You're telling me that's that dry ice in there. There ain't no oxygen in that cooler.
I don't know. I ain't in there.
It's really sad that something that's as smaller than a gnat, little bitty thing like a weevil, gets the best of two big old boys like me and Digger. I'm for putting a little pillow on each one of them's head and smothering him out. I don't know nothing about this stuff.
Don't know. Let's get this big bag of head off of it, young too.
No, not if it'll kill you. So we're going to put some weevil-infested corn into a fur monster, put some dry ice in there with it, and lightly screw on the cap, and we'll see what happens. Look here, it's a smoke.
That's CO2 coming off with that. I think that dry ice is going to be the best avenue to go. As it dissolves, it goes straight from a frozen solid form, bypasses liquid, and goes straight to gas, CO2 gas.
And this won't hurt the grain.
I mean, the seeds in that big seed bank, they're cryogenically frozen down to what? 300 degrees below zero liquid nitrogen?
I don't know. Oh, yeah, there they come.
CO2 is a heavier gas than oxygen. It'll permeate down through the grain. Boom, I believe we'll kill him rascals.
Look here where it stops. That must be where oxygen's at. Hattie, I do not see another bug a-wiggling. Non-wiggler, non-wiggler, non-wiggler.
That there, he just free fell.
He just quit wiggling.
I got, I believe it's killed him, Poop.
Ain't no doubt in my scientific mind it has. I don't see a wiggler nowhere.
Well, if it's that easy, we can do this on a big scale.
Yes, sir.
We can do this a barrel at a time. After a short period of time, we see no weevil activity inside the fur monster. We got to do this on a great big scale.
We've got more grain that we can say grace over. We've got to exterminate these bugs in.
Oh, damn.
So we're going to get bigger barrels in here, fill them up with grain, throw dry ice in there, cap them up, walk off, and leave them, let them die. As this starts gassing off and sublimation's taking place, just kind of a swap out. It falls down, well, in turn, it pushes up on that column of oxygen-rich air and pushes it out through the gasket.
Well, you can tell when the humidity is high, that dry ice, it smokes like mad, don't it? Done is done is done.
If we're lucky enough, we've caught this problem in time before they have destroyed all of our grain.
Just leave it do its thing, I guess.
Yep.
Let's see if we've killed any damn weevils, Poop.
All right. I don't see a weevil on top. They're usually climbing up the sides.
This corn here looks really, really good. Oh, hell yes.
So now that we killed the weevils,
let's see if this corn will molt, puss.
We need to see how much damage they've done, make sure our grain will still sprout. So we've got to get us some corn, get it soaking, get it out on the table, and make sure it will sprout.
I ain't seeing not one critter crawl.
Hell far.
Look at the critters floating to the top.
Look at the damn dead critters are floating to the top.
You can't see them till you hit them with that water, and damn if they don't, they look like salt and pepper. I didn't know there's that many in there, did you?
There's still the same amount of weevils that there was when we started, but fortunately now they all appear to be dead.
None of them wiggling, though.
They ain't damn one of them wiggling, boss man. Honestly, if this won't molt, I don't know that the other ones that were weevily will, but we'll have to try each separate grain. Yeah.
I don't know if it makes any difference to get these bugs out, but...
Yeah, it'll make for better looking liquor.
I'll promise you, some of the liquor that's been made over the years, they've been way worse in it than a few bugs.
I mean, legal distilleries have weevils.
I had a fella in one of them legal distilleries called me one time, and he said, I need some help. I said, well, I ain't looking for a job. He said, no, I just need some advice help. I said, well, what is it? He said, I got maggots in my mash. I said, well, what's your problem? He said, that's my problem. He said, it's got maggots in my cap. I said, well, hell, I said, if a damn fly don't want you liquor, ain't no man going to.
Well, I don't know about that. Fly will run as hard as he can go to get a turd, but I don't know many fellers that will.
Yeah, but we ain't after no turds, we're after liquor.
That's what I love about you, baby man. You always have an answer.
You can't never be caught with your britches down.
But I know you told me your theory one time. If they're asking a question and you answer it, regardless if it's right or not, they don't know that or they wouldn't have been asking the question.
And always act like you know what you're doing. When you're walking through a place and you ain't supposed to be there, if you'll act like you're supposed to be there, then they don't know the better. Carry you a clipboard or something.
We're gonna leave this table to malt, and if we see some sprouts in a few days, then yes, this has been a success. Let's give it a chance and let it do what it's supposed to do. If we don't see any sprouts in a few days, it's been a failure, a complete, total failure. I know one thing, I will have to give you an attaboy for the carbon dioxide. You know, a couple of days have passed now. You know, we're going to check and see if this corn, if there's any sprouts. It smells a little sour in here, don't it?
That'll make good liquor, though, the way it's smelling.
There's a large part of this corn that was damaged by these weevils and will not sprout. But by and large, we're hoping that the majority of it will. And if it does, you know, we're back in business. If it don't, it's back to the grain store. Looky, looky, puss.
Plenty of sprouts.
Wow. I guess the stars all lined up right, or the moonshine gods smiled on us, but we see sprouts. Way more of them have sprouts than don't. Yeah, probably 70% or better. But I know what we got to do.
We got to get it over there immediately.
It's time to kill it, because we don't want them getting any bigger.